Hello, this is Brookings Rail Watch, and today I have a new video series, the Switcher Special. In this series, I will make 2 to 5 minute videos discussing, in depth, specific yard switcher locomotives that I have found over my expeditions. I have a fascination with these machines, and it's almost the signature of my rail expedition videos to feature at least one switcher, usually found sitting by a random co-op. These locomotives are kind of a dying breed. Their decline began in the 60s and 70s when newer, more versatile locomotives started taking their place. They're no longer in the heavy revenue service that they used to be when they were owned by the big Class 1 railroads, and, these days, many are just rotting in shops and on sidings. This video series will document the history of individual engines, engines that usually go unnoticed and unseen, whose stories would otherwise go forgotten. Today's episode is about CEFX 1604. I first came across this blue switcher in May of 2022 when I spotted it in the next town over, Aurora, South Dakota. It's at the big Valero ethanol plant. This plant is so large that there's actually two other switchers on the yard that will get their own videos in the future. 1604 was sitting right next to the public parking lot, so I got some good pictures. It remained at Valero until about August, when it eventually disappeared. EMD SW1500, serial number 4608-40, was built in 1972 and started its life on the Southern Pacific Railroad, numbered 2630. Surprisingly, I actually found a photograph that was taken when it was new. This picture was taken in 1975, when the locomotive was only 3 years old. Years passed by, and at an unknown point in time, 2630 was acquired and repainted by CIT Financial Group. The earliest modern sighting was in 2003 in New Orleans. For the next few years, it stuck around the Dallas-Fort Worth area, primarily in Carrollton, Texas. In the middle of 2011, the switcher started heading north. It went to Illinois, then Missouri, and finally stopped in Wisconsin. It remained near Eau Claire for several more years. In early 2021, it's made its way back to Missouri. It was found at a shop in St. Louis. After this, it had been renumbered to the familiar 1604, so the renumbering likely occurred at the St. Louis shop. In November, 1604 was seen in Wisconsin one more time, but later showed up at Valero. May 2022 is when I saw it for the first time, but I am unaware as to when it actually arrived. As mentioned before, it disappeared that August. That was because it had been sent to RCP&E's main shop in Huron, South Dakota. Unfortunately, when I got the chance to go to Huron in November, it was long gone. And that's the end of 1604's story. As of the time of making this video, there's no new information on where it is, and it's a total mystery as to where it went next. I occasionally check up on these locomotives, so any new info I find, I'll put in the description of the YouTube video. Other than that, that's the end of this video. So I hope you enjoyed it, and I'll see you in the next one.